Now it's the turn of Chiara with Conceptual Photography.
Please, now look at this picture. What do you see?
A bathroom. Two big legs in a little bathroom. A big man in a little bathroom. The portrait of a big man in a little bathroom printed on a book. A man that has in his hands the book. A man in a tunnel that has in his hands the book. The portrait of a man in a tunnel that has in his hands the book in which is printed the photo of the big man in the little bathroom. And where is the portrait? On a tap. And where is the tap? In the bathroom we saw in the first picture, but only now you can see it. Well, what I've just seen is called conceptual photography. Conceptual photography is a type of photography in which the idea that is behind the photograph is much more important than the photo. It comes from conceptual art, and it started in 1960s. The portfolio you saw in the beginning was by one of the most famous conceptual photographers ever, Dwayne Michaels. But there are also contemporary conceptual photographers. For example, there is Ibrahim Al-Rabet, and this is his work called It's Just a Game. It reminds a film by Bergman, and he tried to say that some people underestimate their lives, and that they play with them. There is also Anorexia by Antiago, and it explains how teenagers, especially girls that are anorexics, see themselves in front of their mirrors. But the one I definitely prefer is this one. It's by Alice and it's called I Miss You. It reminds me when I lost someone that was very important for me. And even if apparently I was alive, inside of me I was dead. And even if people told me, come on, you must go on with your old life, I couldn't, because I missed something that was very important for me. This picture made me understand that there was someone in the world that could share my feelings. I also tried to take a conceptual photograph on my own, and as you can see, this is the result. So, what do you think about it? Do you like it? What do you think I wanted to tell you with this picture? Well, I don't know what you've thought, but the thing that I know is that all your thoughts were right, and that's why I like conceptual photography. You can interpret it as you like, because the thing that is important is to think about the serious problems that our society and our world have. Thank you.